Good morning, everyone. In this lesson, we would like to talk to you about one of the most important angles in chip removal, the rake angle. We will see how to identify it in turning operations, its influence on machining, the choice depending on certain aspects, the different connections with the cutting forces, and the power absorbed by the machine. Let's get right to it. I'm Fabrizio, he's Paolo, and this is CNC of Course. The rake angle, also known as the gamma angle, simply defines the angle at which the tool face is positioned in relation to the chip flow on the face. The rake angle is therefore the angle that affects the direction of chip flow, which will have different angles depending on the rake angle. The two images are an enlarged picture of what happens at the point of contact of the chip on the face of the cutter. As soon as the chip makes contact with the face of the tool, it will assume a direction identified by the symbol phi, which, to be precise, indicates the shear angle. Different rake angles result in different shear angles. What, Paolo? So what? This angle is absolutely critical, because it affects the behavior of the chip and the machinability itself. Does that make sense? Great. We'll come back to the link between rake angle and machinability a little later. But first, let's try to identify the angle on our turning tool. Let me start by saying that it's not always easy to identify this angle. Or rather, in turning operations, it's not as complicated as it is in milling or drilling. In the latter two cases, in fact, the angle is located in space and is the result of the summation of other angles involved in machining. So it's not at all easy to identify them. But things are a little simpler in turning, as we have said before. And there are even two types of tool defined according to the rake angle: tools with a negative rake angle and tools with a positive rake angle. If we look at our turning workpiece from the side, keeping in mind that the tip of the insert must be on the center line of the workpiece, we can say that the gamma rake angle is the angle formed between the face of the tool and the center line of the workpiece, and that, apart from the numerical value, it is defined as negative when the face of the tool is above the center line of the workpiece, and the rake angle is positive when the face of the tool is below the center line of the workpiece. From now on, we will call positive tools those with a positive rake angle, and negative tools those with a negative rake angle. The photo itself shows the many implications of these two types of angles, so much so that in the workshop, many people organize tools according to which family they belong to. And in fact, many manufacturers also do this in the pages of their catalogs, precisely because the differences are substantial, starting with the difference in the forces generated. It doesn't take an engineer to work out that a positive tool generates less cutting force than a negative tool, most obviously because the negative tool tends to almost oppose chip formation. But to be more precise, let's analyze the two cutting edges in the chip formation process, assuming that we are machining the same type of material with the same parameters and the same volume of chips removed. If we measure the thickness of the chip with a micrometer by taking a real one from our machine tool, we will notice a curious thing. The thickness of the chip generated with the positive tool will be less than the thickness generated with the negative tool. In other words, in one case compared to the other, the tool will deform the same amount of material, but will do so in a different way, thus generating different thicknesses, with consequent differences in the cutting forces generated. Positive tool, less chip thickness for the same volume of chip removed per minute, less force, and consequently, we can add less cutting power. And from all of this, we can already identify some practical applications. We will use positive tools in all cases where it is essential to keep cutting forces low to avoid breakage or vibration. For example, we will use positive tools for internal finishing operations with tools having very high overhangs, or in external finishing operations where it is the workpiece that can vibrate due to very high overhangs. In addition, from a practical point of view, chip evacuation with positive rake angles is faster. There is less friction and lower temperatures in the cutting zone, making it ideal for machining thermoplastic materials where high operating temperatures can damage the workpiece material. As we look at the list of the various differences, we see that the aspects marked in green are all on the side of the positive tools. So let's see what Paolo thinks about it. What do you think, Paolo? Sure, Paolo. Positive tools, positive aspects. Only you could come to that conclusion. You're probably thinking that's why they are called positive tools. But if you're so smart, then what are the most common tools in the workshop or in steelworking? Positive, Paolo. I knew you would say that, but this time the answer is wrong. The tool most commonly found in workshops where steel is machined, and I specify, Paolo, steels, is the negative tool, and the reason why is linked to three fundamental aspects. Firstly, greater insert strength. Let's compare the two tools and focus on the clearance angle of the insert, which is defined by the second letter in the insert nomenclature. As we can also see from the drawing, the positive tool must necessarily have a rake angle greater than 0 degrees, for example, 5 degrees. Because if it were at 0 degrees, it would heel with the lower part of the insert against the workpiece. Consequently, we will have an insert that will have an angle between the face and the lower flank of 90 degrees. On the other hand, an insert mounted on a negative tool may well have a clearance angle of 0 degrees. Therefore, the letter N will appear in the ISO letters. This allows an angle between face and flank of 90 degrees, making the insert more robust and therefore much more suitable for heavy machining, roughing, interrupted cuts, machining of high-strength steels. The second reason why the negative tool is very popular is closely linked to the first reason. In fact, the negative tool, thanks to the fact that it has a clearance angle equal to 0 degrees, allows the insert to be used on both faces, becoming double-sided, significantly lowering costs, because a negative insert with a slightly higher cost than the single-sided one provides twice as many cutting edges. Finally, the third reason. Let's go back to the picture on chip thickness. We said that the negative tool creates a greater chip thickness, and on one hand, this is a disadvantage because with the same volume of chip removed, it generates more stress on the face of the cutting edge. But on the other hand, a greater chip thickness is exactly what we need when turning on steels. So to sum up, when we have said the pros and cons of the two angles, we can say that positive tools generate less chip thickness, consequently less cutting effort and lower cutting power input and temperatures generated. On the other hand, the cutting edge of the insert is more delicate and less convenient economically than the same insert that is double-sided. So, we will choose the positive insert in conditions where we need to avoid the occurrence of vibrations related to the overhang of the workpiece or tool. We will use the positive insert in certain types of finishing where it is very important to keep the stresses and temperatures in the cutting zone low, so it is also suitable for reducing the occurrence of the buildup edge. The negative tool, on the other hand, generates more stress but is much more robust, making it suitable for roughing and interrupted cutting. Thanks to its greater chip thickness, it allows better machinability and is therefore suitable for machining materials with long chips. Although, it should be noted that the negative tool generates more cutting forces and therefore higher operating temperatures. We would like to conclude this lesson with a very important practical consideration concerning the positive tool. If we look in any tool catalog, it will be almost impossible to find a truly positive tool today, especially for external turning operations. In other words, the positive tool in our drawing will not be easy to find on the market. We will find the tool with a zero rake angle, so the tool that has the face exactly coinciding with the axis of the workpiece. Although this tool has a zero rake angle, it is considered positive, and the reason for this is related to two aspects. The first is that it will have to mount an insert with a clearance angle greater than zero, so single-sided inserts are less robust than inserts mounted on negative tools. The second reason is that in most cases, it will be the shape of the chip breaker that makes it positive. In today's lesson, we have always shown inserts with no chip breaker geometry, also called flat face inserts. Let us now take an insert with chip breaker geometry and try to see whether the chip breaker geometry has any influence on the side rake angle. To do this, we analyze the insert alone. Positioned as if it were mounted on a negative tool, we cut it along its side where chip formation takes place. From the photo, it is clear how the chip breaker geometry affects the rake angle. which at this point we will call the effective rake angle, because it is the angle that really affects the chip sliding angle, the angle we talked about at the start of the lesson. The chip breaker geometry, as in this case, could even transform an insert that is positioned negatively on the tool into an actually positive tool, thanks to its geometry. We can therefore say that chip breaker geometries play a fundamental role on the rake angle, to such an extent that in some cases, a tool that had a negative rake angle insert mounting can become positive. So, as a good operator and programmer, if you are going to be asked to choose a tool, you will need to be familiar with the tool, but also with its geometry. And you will need to use this information to your advantage. Because what counts in the chip formation process is, firstly, the effective rake angle, and secondly, in terms of the robustness of the tool, the side rake angle of the tool itself. In conclusion, today we have seen the most important chip removal angle, that is, the rake angle. We have learned how to identify it. We have seen how it influences cutting forces and cutting power. We have learned how to choose it according to the material and the operation to execute. And finally, we have learned how this angle is related to the geometry of the cutting edges of the inserts. Well, now all that remains is for Paolo and I to thank you for your attention. We'll see you at the next lesson, always here on CNC, of course. Bye, everyone.